Good morning, my dear students. I hope all of you are fit and fine in your homes and taking care of yourself. Dear students, nowadays it is very important to be safe and to follow all the precautions of the lockdown. So I hope all of you are doing this and keeping yourself and your family members safe. Please be careful. Don't be lazy about it at all. Now, dear students, in today's lesson, we are going to once again read the chapter in the Kingdom of Fools. Okay, this is a very interesting story and I hope all of you are enjoying it. Right, this story must have made you laugh a couple of times or even more than that. So today, once again, we will be resuming the story. Okay, now my dear students, what we have before us, first of all, what we have read up to now in this current chapter. Okay, so we have got to know that there is a kingdom in which there is a stupid king and there is a stupid minister. Everything in this city is different compared to other cities. Okay, why it is different? Because in this city there are different people, there are the people, they are made to follow stupid laws. Okay, what kind of stupid laws? Like day is night and night is day. Okay, then what happens? One day a guru and his disciple, they came to this town and they went around and found the town quite strange. So then when they spent some more time, they got to know how people here, they think day is night and night is day, and even the animals behave like that only. So after that, what happens? The disciple, he decides to stay in the city only, while the guru warns him that do not stay here because these are very stupid people. Then, ignoring the advice of the guru, the disciple, he decides to stay in the city only. Okay, then a thief tries to commit to steal something from a rich merchant and he dies in the process because a wall falls upon him. So when this complaint reaches the king, he orders the execution of the merchant. Then a funny game starts, the blame game starts. The merchant, he placed the fault on the bricklayer. The bricklayer says he was distracted due to a girl. Then the girl, she says that she had to go up and down the street, that street, again and again because of the jeweler. The jeweler says that I did what I did because of a rich merchant. And the rich merchant, upon whom the blame was finally placed, he was none other than the father of the rich merchant's father of the rich merchant in whose house the thief tried to commit the burglary and he tried to steal. Okay, he was the same rich merchant. So the king ruled that because a son inherits wealth from his father, similarly he also inherits sin. Although except the thief, no one was at fault, but still he did this so that the fault, it can be placed upon someone. Okay, so this is our story. And then moving on, they think that okay, now we have to punish this person, and they build a new stead, okay, to execute the guilty. but the stead was too small for a thin person, and it was then thought of that, okay, let's find a fat man. And who was the fat man, fat person in the city at that time? It was the disciple. So the disciple was asked to die. He was the prison, the soldiers of the king, they took him and he was placed, even though there was no fault of him. Okay, it is the city of fools where foolish things are happening. Okay, so it is without any of his fault, he was asked to die. Then he requested his guru to help him, and his guru came promptly. He came at once to help him. He said to the king that he starts fighting with the disciple, and the king, he gets confused seeing this. So he asked the guru that, why do you want to die? So the guru tells him that, I want to die because whosoever will die will be reborn as the king of this country. Okay, the first person who dies will be born as the king of this country. The second person will be born as the minister of this country. Okay, so this the guru has said. Okay, the guru has said this to the king. Now let's see, let's read and find out how the king reacts to the statement and what happens in the kingdom of fools. So everyone, please take out page number 25. Okay, I'll be starting with the previous line which we did. We are sick of our ascetic life. Okay, वो अपनी साधु जैसी life, जो संतों वाली उनकी normal life थी, जिसमें कोई distraction नहीं थे, उससे परेशान हो गए थे. It would be nice to enjoy ourselves as king and minister for a while. So for some time they wanted to be king and minister. Now keep your word. Keep your word means keep your promise. Keep your promise, my lord, and put us to death. Okay, now keep your word and put us to death. Kill us. Me first. Remember. So he says this. The king was now thrown into deep thought. जो king था वो अब एक गहरी सोच में चला गया था. Okay, he was thinking very deeply about something, very intensely, very seriously about something. Okay, so he didn't want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of life. Now see, because he is a stupid king, he is a fool, he is focusing that I should not lose this kingdom to someone else in the next life. He is not worried about his present situation. Okay, only a foolish person can think like that, that he is not worried about his present situation. But what else he is worried about? He is worried about his future. Okay, he is worried about his future. He needed time. Okay, he needed time. He wanted to make a plan. He needed time so that he could make a plan and he could think of something so that he retains the kingdom. Kingdom chahiye tha usse. वो चाहता था कि इस लाइफ में तो मैं किंग बन ही गया हूं, नेक्स्ट लाइफ में भी मैं ही किंग बनूं. ओके, सो गुरु की का जो ये थॉट था, गुरु ने जो कहा था कि अगर हम मर जाएंगे तो हम एज जो भी मरेगा वह एज किंग पैदा होगा. सो इस बात को किंग ने बहुत ही सीरियसली ले लिया. ओके, सो ही ऑर्डर्ड द एग्जीक्यूशन पोस्टपोन्ड टू द नेक्स्ट डे. सो बिकॉज उसको टाइम चाहिए था, तो उसने सबसे पहला स्टेप क्या किया, उसने ऑर्डर किया कि एग्जीक्यूशन जो है वो नेक्स्ट डे, मतलब अगले दिन करो. ओके, एग्जीक्यूशन उसी टाइम पे होने वाला था, बट उसने बिकॉज उसको टाइम चाहिए था सोचने के लिए, उसने उसको डिले करने के लिए ऑर्डर किया कि नहीं, आज नहीं, नेक्स्ट डे करोगे इसे. सो ही ordered the execution postponed. Postponed क्या होता है कि उसको बाद के लिए शेड्यूल कर देना. ओके, पोस्टपोनिंग समथिंग इज कि उसको बाद के लिए शेड्यूल करना. सो ही ordered द एग्जीक्यूशन postponed टू द नेक्स्ट डे एंड talked इन सीक्रेट विद his मिनिस्टर. सो मिनिस्टर तो उसका ट्रस्टेड एडवाइजर था, राइट? उसने फिर सोचा कि चलो अब मैं अपने मिनिस्टर से बात करता हूँ. बट वी ऑल नो दैट हाउ स्मार्ट दिस मिनिस्टर पर्सन इज, राइट? वी ऑल नो दैट ही इज वेरी स्मार्ट. ही इज जस्ट लाइक हिज किंग. एज स्मार्ट द किंग इज, एज स्मार्ट इज द मिनिस्टर. ओके, बोथ ऑफ देम आर इक्वली इंटेलिजेंट. It's not right for us to give over the kingdom to others in the next life. So the king, what is he saying? The king, he is saying that it is not right for us. Okay, ये हमारे लिए सही नहीं कि in the next life over, जो हमारा अगला जन्म होगा उसमें हम ये kingdom किसी और को दे दें. Okay? वो इस life के बारे में worried नहीं है, वो अगली life के बारे में worried है. उसने कह दिया है कि इट्स नॉट राइट फॉर अस, हमारे लिए ये चीज राइट नहीं है. क्योंकि अब वो क्या रीजन, लेट्स रीड एंड सी. लेट्स गो ऑन द स्टेक आवरसेल्व्स एंड वी विल बी रीबॉर्न एज किंग एंड मिनिस्टर अगेन. ओके, सो वो क्या कह रहे हैं कि चलो हम ही स्टेक पे चले जाते हैं, हम ही जो सूली है उस पे चढ़ के हम मर जाते हैं. ओके, एंड then what will happen, we will be reborn. Reborn means punarjanam, फिर से we will be born as king and minister again, right? So this is the plan of the king. Holy men do not tell lies. Holy men means जो धार्मिक आदमी होते हैं, जो भी ये साधु संन्यासी वगैरह होते हैं, संत होते हैं, ये झूठ नहीं बोलते, right? But was he telling a lie? Was the guru? So, was the guru telling a lie? Obviously, he was telling a lie. It was not truth. It was not true what he was saying. Okay? But still, because he knew that he is dealing with a foolish person, he said what he said. Okay? So, this question also might come in your exam that was the guru right to tell a lie to the king? And then think what you will write, what will be your answer. Holy men do not tell lies, he said, and the minister agreed. So, jo minister tha usne kya kiya? Agree kiya. King ne to foolish baat kari hi, king ne ek stupid suggestion diya, minister ne uske saath use agree kiya. So he told the executioners. Executioners कौन होते हैं? जो जल्लाद होता है, जो भी उधर उसको मारते हैं, वो executioners होते हैं. We will send the criminals tonight. Okay, हम criminals को आज रात भेजेंगे. When the first man comes to you, put him to death first. Okay, so जब first person आएगा, पहले उसे मारना है. Okay. Then do the same to the second man. Okay, जो second आएगा उसको फिर आपने फिर से मारना है. Those are my orders. Don't make any mistake. So उसने executioners को ये order दे दी कि first of all you have to kill the first person, then you have to kill the second person. Okay? और ये मेरे orders है, there should be no mistake. कोई भी आपको mistake नहीं करनी, कुछ गलती नहीं होनी चाहिए. That night, the king and his minister went secretly to the prison. So secretly, they both went to the prison. Released the guru and the disciple. फिर उन्होंने prison में जाके क्या किया? जो guru और उसका disciple था, जो उसका चेला था, उसको छोड़ दिया. उन्हें release कर दिया. Disguised themselves as the two. Disguise means to change look or appearance. जो हमारा लुक है, अपीयरेंस है, उसको चेंज करना। सो उन्होंने डिस्गाइज कैसे कर बना लिया लुक को करके, जो गुरु और उसका डिसिपल था उसके जैसे। ओके, एंड एज अरेंज्ड बिफोर हैंड विद लॉयल सर्वेंट्स वर टेकन टू द स्टेक एंड प्रॉम्प्टली एग्जीक्यूटेड। सो उनके जो सर्वेंट्स के साथ उनका ऑलरेडी डिस्कशन हुआ था, उसके अकॉर्डिंग ही वो कहाँ गए, वो स्टेक पे गए और प्रॉम्प्टली मीन्स इमिडिएटली विदाउट एनी गैप उनका एग्जीक्यूशन हो गया, उनको मार दिया। ओके, देन व्हेन द बॉडीज वर टेकन डाउन टू बी थ्रोन टू क्रोज एंड वल्चर्स द पीपल पैनिक्ड। ओके, सो बॉडी को क्या करते थे वो लोग, वो क्रोज या वल्चर्स को थ्रो कर देते थे। ओके, लेकिन जब वो उनको उतारा गया, जब उनको उतारा गया तो फिर वहां पे लोगों ने क्या किया, पैनिक कर दिया। पैनिक करते एक सिचुएशन ऑफ टेंशन एंड वरी। ओके, लोग परेशान हो गए, ये देख के कि वो बॉडीज किसकी थी, और वो बॉडीज थी दे बिलोंग टू द किंग एंड हिज मिनिस्टर। They saw before them the dead bodies of the king and the minister. The city was in confusion. Ab city confused ho gayi. Why they were confused? Because they were the king and the minister. Death kis kyun nahi thi? Guru and his disciple. But who died in place of them? The king and his minister. All night they mourned and discussed the future of the kingdom. Mourn kiya unhone? मौन करना क्या होता है, उन्होंने शोक जताया, उन्होंने उनको उनका के नाम पे शोक जताया कि हाँ ये इनकी डेथ हो गई, ऐसे नहीं होना चाहिए। ओके, सम पीपल सडनली थॉट ऑफ द गुरु एंड द डिसिपल एंड कॉट अप विद देम एज दे वर प्रिपेयरिंग टू लीव टाउन अननोटिस। कॉट अप मींस कि उनसे मिल गए। ओके, सो किसी ने गुरु और उसके चेले के बारे में सोचा और वो लोग उनसे मिल गए, जबकि गुरु और वो चेला क्या कर रहे थे, वो टाउन जो था उसको छोड़ के जा रहे थे बिना किसी को नोटिस हुए, बिना किसी को दिखे। ओके, वी पीपल नीड अ किंग एंड अ मिनिस्टर। सो उन लोगों ने कहा कि हम लोगों को एक किंग और मिनिस्टर चाहिए। सेड समवन, अदर्स एग्रीड। राइट, वो तो हर किंगडम को चाहिए होता किंग और मिनिस्टर। दे बेग्ड द गुरु and the disciple to be their king and their minister. Beg karna means bheek mangna. So unhone in a sort of itna request kiya ki wo ek tarah se begging hi tha. Unhone bahut request kara king aur guru se, guru aur disciple se ki wo unke king aur minister ban jaye. It didn't take many arguments to persuade the disciple. Persuade means request to do something. So ज़्यादा आर्ग्यूमेंट्स नहीं लगे डिसिपल को परसुएड करने में। ओके, डिसिपल को जो चेला था उसको मनाने में ज़्यादा आर्ग्यूमेंट्स नहीं लगे। बट इट टुक लॉन्गर टू परसुएड द गुरु। गुरु को फिर भी मनाने में ज़्यादा टाइम लगा। ओके, दे फाइनली एग्रीड टू रूल द किंगडम ऑफ द फूलिश किंग एंड द सिली मिनिस्टर। फूलिश मीन्स जो स्टूपिड होता है, और सिली कौन होता है, जो बहुत ज़्यादा स्मार्ट नहीं होता, जिसमें इंटेलिजेंस नहीं होती। On the condition that they could change all the old laws. So, जितने भी पुराने laws थे वो उनको change करने वाले थे, इस condition पे वो king और minister बने। From then on, night would again be night and day would again be day. So, फिर क्या हुआ कि night हो गई, day हो गया। Why? Because they were smart. Okay, they were intelligent. And you could get nothing for a doo-doo. So, एक डूडू का आपको कुछ भी नहीं मिलेगा। ओके, करेंसी भी जैसे सब जगह चलते वैसे होने लगी। इट बिकेम लाइक एनी अदर प्लेस। ओके, सो ये हर जैसे और जगह होते वैसे ही जगह हो गया। ओके, सो आफ्टर द गुरु एंड द डिसिपल दे बिकेम द किंग एंड द मिनिस्टर, द किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स वॉज नो मोर द किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स। ओके, so it was a Kannad folk tale from A.K. Ramanujan's folk tales from India. It was a Kannad folk tale. Folk tale क्या होती है, मैंने बताया था starting में भी, लोक कथाएं। okay, Now, dear students, let's discuss the question answers. Think about it. The first question is, what are the two strange things that the guru and his disciple find in the kingdom of fools? Very easy question. Just in the beginning, there something related to time is there. Just mention that. Okay. And one other thing is related to money. So just mention those two things and you are done. Why does the disciple decide to stay in the kingdom of fools? How he became fat? If you know that, then you also know why he decided to stay in the kingdom of fools. Is it a good idea? Was it a good idea? You people know the answer very well. Name all the people who are tried in the king's court and give the reasons for their trial. Okay, so now in this question, please remember, whenever such questions come, you don't have to give your answer point wise. Okay, write your answer in a paragraph. You can make one or two paragraphs, that's fine, or even three, but your answer should not be too long. And dear students, the word limit for these questions is 30 to 50. For the longer questions, write 60 to 80 words, okay, but not more than that. Who is the real culprit according to the king? Why does he escape punishment? So when the king finally gave his judgment, then he placed the fall upon whom? He placed the blame upon whom? You have to write the name of that person, and the reason was related to the stake, okay, the stake which was built. So explain that and you'll have your answer. What are the guru's words of wisdom? So guru, when he gave the warning to his disciple, he said a few words. What were those words? You have to mention that. Okay. And when does the disciple remember them? At what point of time? What happens in the story? In which situation does the disciple remember them? How does the guru manage to save his disciple's life? So this will be a little long answer. You can write it between 100 to 150 words. Okay. So write it completely, write it properly. And if you have any confusion, anything, any questions related to the question answers, then please let me know. Okay. So dear students, this is your chapter in the kingdom of fools. We have completed this and that's your lesson for today. Thank you.